Hip bone is a large irregular bone comprising of ilium superiorly. It has expanded iliac crest with prominent anterior superior iliac spine. It also consists of pubis antero-inferiorly and ischium postero-inferiorly. The three parts are joined at a cup-shaped hollow, the acetabulum. Pubis and ischium are separated by a large opening called the obturator foramen. Acetabulum articulates with head of femur to form the stable hip joint. Side determination. Flat ilium lies above the acetabulum. Acetabulum is directed laterally. Obturator foramen is below the acetabulum. Anatomical position. Anterior superior iliac spine and pubic symphysis lie in the same coronal plane. Pelvic surface of pubis is directed backwards and upwards. The symphysial surface of body of pubis lies in the median plane. Ilium. Ilium forms the upper expanded end of the hip bone. It comprises two ends, three borders and three surfaces. The ends are, upper end is the iliac crest, lower end fuses with pubis and ischium in the acetabulum. Borders, anterior, posterior and medial. Surfaces, iliac surface, gluteal surface and the sacropelvic surface. The iliac crest. Iliac crest is convex upwards. Antero-posteriorly it is concave inwards and concave outwards behind. Anterior end of iliac crest is the anterior superior iliac spine. It is felt at the anterior end of the crest. Posterior end is called posterior superior iliac spine. It is seen as a dimple 4 cm lateral to the sacral 2 vertebra. Iliac crest is divided into a long ventral segment and a short dorsal segment. Long ventral segment comprises outer lip, intermediate area and inner lip. The tubercle of iliac crest lies 5 cm behind the anterior superior iliac spine. The short dorsal segment comprises lateral slope and a medial slope. Borders. Anterior border starts at anterior superior iliac spine. This is followed by a shallow notch. Its lower part shows another spine known as the anterior inferior iliac spine. The posterior border starts from a dimpled posterior superior iliac spine, runs downwards till it reaches posterior inferior iliac spine. It continues as the greater sciatic notch. Medial border. Medial border lies on the inner aspect of hip bone from posterior part of iliac crest to the iliopubic eminence. Surfaces. the gluteal surface, lies on the outer surface of ilium and is divided into four areas by three lines. The posterior gluteal line is the shortest. It starts from posterior superior iliac spine and goes down till the almost the posterior inferior iliac spine. The anterior gluteal line starts 2.5 centimeter in front of the tubercle of the iliac crest and it passes downwards and reaches almost the middle of the greater sciatic notch. The inferior gluteal line starts slightly anterior to that behind anterior superior iliac spine and ends at the apex of greater sciatic notch. The iliac fossa. The iliac fossa lies on the inner surface of ilium, forming the lateral wall of the false pelvis. Sacropelvic surface. The sacropelvic surface lies behind the medial border. It has three parts: the iliac tuberosity, raised in the middle and depressed above and below it. The auricular surface lies below the iliac tuberosity, articulates with the sacrum to form the strong sacroiliac joint. Pelvic surface lies anteroinferior to auricular surface. It contains a pre-auricular sulcus and it forms the lateral wall of true pelvis. The attachments. Anterior superior iliac spine gives attachment to the lateral end of inguinal ligament. And it also gives origin to a long muscle known as the sartorius. The pubis. Pubis forms anteroinferior part of hip bone and 1/5 of the acetabulum. Pubis comprises a body, superior ramus and inferior ramus. The body is flattened with an upper border called pubic crest. At the lateral end of pubic crest is a prominent pubic tubercle. This is an important landmark from hernia point of view. Surfaces. Anterior rough surface is directed downwards. Pelvic or posterior surface faces upwards. It is smooth and is related to urinary bladder. The medial or symphysial surface forms secondary cartilaginous joint with the opposite pubic bone. It is a midline joint and midline joints are mostly secondary cartilaginous in nature. The superior ramus extends from the body to the acetabulum, lying above the obturator foramen. The borders of superior ramus, pectineal line or superior border is from pubic crest to iliopectineal eminence. Anterior border is from pubic tubercle to the acetabular notch. An inferior border forms the upper margin of obturator foramen. Surfaces. The pectineal surface lies between anterior and superior borders. Pelvis surface lies between superior and inferior borders. Surfaces. The pectineal surface lies between anterior and superior borders. Pelvic surface between superior and inferior borders. Obturator surface between anterior and inferior borders. Inferior ramus. The inferior ramus extends between the body of pubis to the ramus of ischium, below obturator foramen. It forms a conjoint ischiopubic rami with the ramus of ischium. Now, last, ischium forms posteroinferior part of hip bone and it forms 2/5 part of the acetabulum. It forms also the posterior boundary of the obturator foramen. It comprises of a body and a ramus arising at acute angle from the body. Body has two ends. Upper end forms part of the acetabulum. Lower end forms the ischial tuberosity. It has got three borders. Anterior border forms posterior margin of acetabulum. Posterior border shows ischial spine. It continues with the lesser sciatic notch. And lateral border forms lateral border of the ischial tuberosity. The prominent ischial tuberosity. It is divided by a transverse ridge into an upper and lower areas. Upper area is divided by an oblique line into a supralateral and an inferomedial part. The lower area is divided into an outer and inner part. The ramus of ischium. It is a single ramus of ischium which unites with the inferior ramus of pubis to form the conjoint ischiopubic rami. This rami has two borders, upper and lower, two surfaces, outer and inner. The upper border forms margin of obturator foramen and lower border forms part of pubic arch.